Will we see these pieces in other parts of the world?
Yes, just a couple of months ago, we got the go signal to sell all over the world. So we'll be joining the Star Wars conventions, Comic-Con.
Isn't there one chair now that we call the Brad Pitt chair? Or nickname it?
No, actually, no.
I bought two of them because you said that.
He's been
that was your selling point to me in Cebu.
He's been a fan, I guess, for a couple of years before I even knew that you could use the Brad Pitt angle to sell. Because it's not cool to say,
oh, no,
hey, so-and-so bought this.
That's true. But it will come out, especially with social media and all. And then also for his children before, or his first baby, I think it was.
Yeah.
He made the whole
crib. For Maddox,
the cocoon.
Yeah. Actually, it wasn't a crib. He got the whole bed for his baby to sleep in, in true Hollywood fashion.
Oh, of course. And a lot of people have seen this and have fallen in love with your work. How does it make you feel?
No, it makes me feel good. I mean, as a kid, I liked it. I loved it when my designs put a smile on my mom's face, and I'm still doing that today.
She must be so proud of you.
Yes.
With all that you're doing now, my gosh, the international fame that you've acquired at such a young age.
No, I'm not that young.
Well, looking at your history, I said, wait a minute. I thought this guy was a child. You've done so much as a young man, a Cebuano at that. And the best thing about you that I talked to a lot of Cebuanos, when I do shows there, you wouldn't think that you were this popular because you keep yourself grounded. Is that a Cebuano thing or a Chinese thing?
I don't know. I think it's when I look at all the things that I haven't done and I still have to do, that keeps me always grounded.